12 redstone. 12 redstone.
Hey guys, how's it going? It's me, of course, Dolinmyster, and we are back in some more Sky Factory 3. Oh yeah. So today, you might notice there's a few things that are a little bit different. For instance, the thing behind me is missing. Yeah, that's a pretty big thing. The entire thing... Oh, I thought that was a fixed bug. It must be a 111 fixed bug. Okay. In previous versions of Minecraft, you couldn't shift on chests. In case you didn't know that, a fun way to troll people. Because you're like, hey, look down there. Why I'm falling? Anyways. Yeah, I removed the mob farm. It wasn't working. I went many locations around out here, and I could not get it to spawn anything at all. So I got rid of it. I got rid of it and I made this platform. And I'm pretty happy with this. So this is obviously where we started originally. And as you can see now, it's got a big circle area for it. And that obviously connects the different areas off into the different areas and whatnot and comes to the center point here. I thought that was cool. So the next thing I want to do from here now is build a mob farm. So one question I do have, and this is something I'll need to test, and it's pretty easy to test, is if you die, where do you spawn? Because I believe spawn was right here, where the bedrock is, which is right underneath it. So what I can do easily is just dump my inventory, make sure I've got nothing else on me. Yep, and we're good. And I can go break my bed and move it over one spot, and we can just jump into the void and die. And see what happens. Why did I go this way? This is not where my bed is. Oh yeah, everything's gone. Like I got rid of everything from the center here. And I moved it all. It's all in chests right now. And it's kind of an ugly mess, but whatever. I got it moved. That's really all that was important, right? Right. So let's move my bed. And we can do this. And move it here. Not set our spawn. And let's just jump. Oh, it looks really cool from down here. Oh, no, it doesn't look like anything because I'm dead. Okay, so yes, that is the spawn spot. I mean, that's what I figured. I pretty much guessed that, but I just, you know, I want to make sure of these things. So the next question is, if I build something here, where will I spawn? And why am I only getting 50 FPS now? That's weird. There we go. Now we're better. Because it won't spawn you in a cave. It'll spawn you above it. So if I take this and basically if I take some blocks here, right? And if we had a mob farm that fell to this exact spot. Why can I not place block on you? There we go. Because it was being weird. We're just doing a little testing here, guys. So just bear with me for a few minutes here while I try to figure some stuff out. Because I'm pretty sure I know the answer to a lot of these things, but I wanted to make sure. So let's say we had a mob farm, all right? Let's say this is the inside of the mob farm, yada, yada, yada. I'm sure this is a spawning area. It's about to become nighttime. And oh, wait, there's light right here. Excellent. So this is our spawn platform, blah, blah, blah. Everything falls down in there and so on and so forth, right? I can't even get to that chest. I have nothing on me. You know what? There's stuff in there. That's fine. We'll just take these with me. And knives. I'm going to come down here and break this block anyways. Bye, blocks. All right. So we've died again. Yeah. That's exactly what I thought was going to happen. So it spawns me on top. There's a couple ways to fix that. So my goal is to have it's weird. I die and then when I come back, I've just got lag. My goal is to kind of have a... Did I die right next to my other body? Huh. That's cool. To have a mob farm here in the center, right? And what I can do is I can put some sort of platform on top to teleport down from, so that when it spawns me on top, like it will, I have a way to get down. And that's sort of my thought, what I'm probably going to end up doing. And that should be fine. I think I'll be okay with that. So what I should really do is take this circle platform that we have here. And let's see here. I can offset this, right? Offset negative one. Are you... This is probably why. Let's do 9. Uh-huh. And then if we do show, that's way too tall. Way too tall. But that's kind of what I want to do. And this will be, so we'll have a platform up there that we can go up to. You know what? Can I do a dome? Bet I can. There's domes in here, right? Solid cylinder, solid top dome, solid bottom dome, top dome. Okay. What do you look like? And how do I support preview mode? Top dome. Probably need to set this to like 10, and then this to maybe 0. I don't know, Dadcraft's the genius at this stuff. Oh, hey, look, there we go. Okay, so that's the dome. So yeah. So what we can do is we can go ahead and adjust this, and let's just say like 15. And then that gives us a decent dome that we can work with. And then what we can have is this will be a dome, and then we can take this, and what we'll do is we'll end up connecting this off to the main area. That's a little short still looking. But this should connect up perfectly, right? It's a little derpy here, but that's fine. That's easy enough to fix. I can place block there and place a block there and do what needs to be done. So that should be pretty dang cool if you ask me. Yeah, I think that'll be good. So one thing we should probably do also is set my new spawn, since I moved the bed and I'd like to respawn in my bed and on top of the platform. So there shouldn't be an issue that I'll ever have, but if I ever share the world or whatever, it'll be a small issue. You might die coming down from the top. I'll figure something out for that. I'm not too worried. That was just a curiosity. If my bed ever gets broken and I don't have a new bed to place or a new place to spawn, it's, you know, nice to kind of have these things figured out. So let's go ahead, and we're not going to worry about that right now. What I do want to worry about, though, is getting rid of death point 1 and 2. And then going ahead and grabbing my stuff back out from inside of here. Let's also break these blocks so they're not sitting here anymore. That's weird. And I never... Somebody asked me if I was, you know, using a... Oh, cool. I am using the sound filters mod that we have in FTB Hermit Pack. So in case you're wondering why there's, you know, a lot of echoey noises and whatnot, that's why. Because I do have that installed, and I like it, which is part of the reason. And it adds a couple of really cool things that I do like. One of them mainly is the fact that sound effects don't work around corners the way they're supposed to, which I think is kind of cool in my opinion. But there's like this really neat feature where, like, if there's a sound here and I'm over here, I won't hear the sound, or it won't be as loud. It'll be muffled, which is a really neat feature. Yeah, and I like it. But what I'd like to do today is I'd like to go ahead and take a look at our jetpack options, because I would like some flight. I think it's going to help me out. It makes it a lot easier to build a spawner of some sort. And I would like to take a look at the conductive iron jetpack, since that's really the only kind of flight that we have other than the angel ring or the nano beacon, which we are not anywhere near even making the tier 1, I don't think. Yeah, it needs dragon's breath. A beacon, blocks of gold. Modifier, of course. Yeah, we are. So we need to find a wither and a dragon to get the nano beacon. Okay. I mean, I figured as much, but I wasn't sure. So, and the ring of flight is going to be really, really difficult just because of what we need to do to get some of these things. You know, the gas, I'm not even sure. I mean, we could build a spawner, I guess, to get gas. So it's not a big deal, but it's just annoying. And then obviously the bats, those are both kind of going to be a pain in the butt to get. So I'm not going to worry about that. Then there's also the wings of the bat, which shouldn't be too hard. But again, we need to kill a wither. So, oh, and we need to kill the dragon. So we need to kill the dragon and we need to kill the wither. So again, can you make dragon's breath? No. Can we make nether stars? No. Okay, I didn't think so. I don't know other than maybe Batania, and it's Batania. Does Batania still have the things? These things. Yeah, the Flugel Tiaras. But these require Gaia Spirit and Elementium. So, and again, oh, and Ender Air Bottles. So again, not gonna happen. So all this flight is super end game, and the Flugel Tiara, I'm really surprised with how expensive it is that it's not that it's not good. It's just, it's different. I like the Flugel Tiara and some of the stuff that it does. It's a pretty cool form of flight. The only downside is that it's not permanent flight. Like, it's a quick temporary flight, which I think is weird, but whatever. That's all I really think of. Maybe the Supremium Armor, I think is what it's called. Supremium Armor. I think grants flight set bonus flight. So you can actually get flight through that. But again, that needs another star. So we're not near that at all. Although I look forward to getting the Supremium. Supremium is pretty dang OP. If I understand correctly. And I think that's it. I could be wrong. You guys can probably tell me if I'm wrong or not. I don't think there's any other sort of flight mechanic that we have in the game. Trying to think. I don't believe anyone else has any kind of jetpacks or anything like that. So it's probably our only good options that we have. Is making the jetpack from Simply Jetpacks. I think that's still called Simply Jetpacks. Maybe it's just Simply Jetpacks Reborn, because everything's reborn in 110. Simply Jetpacks 2. There we go. So let's go ahead and start working on what we need to do to get this guy going. First things first, we need an alloy smeltery, because we don't have one. And I can't just craft this stuff. So we need to make an alloy smeltery. Not too expensive. A couple furnaces, machine chassis, a cauldron, and some iron. So pretty cheap. And we have some copper. So we need a copper ingot. Do I have any gold nuggets? Nuggety nuggets of gold? Gold? Nope. Okay, I didn't think so. So we need gold. We've got our copper, we need our redstone. Oh, wait a minute. Did I forget to see if we had any redstone? I think I did. Let's grab these guys real quick. These are the chests from out in the main area. And let's just go ahead and set them down over here. Okay, there we go. That's all of you. That's all of you. There is no redstone in either of those chests. And I don't think there's any redstone in here either. There's redstonia. Restonia. Okay. So since there's no redstone, I'm going to have to put some redstone together. So let me do that real quick. We'll be right back after I've gotten some redstone, and then we will go from there. Because I didn't put it in here, right? No, I put my diamonds in there though. I never have anything that I need. All right, guys, we'll be right back in just a second. After I've had a little bit of time to sift, let's go for one, two, three, four stacks of cobblestone. I like that. That's a good number. We'll be right back. 12 redstone. 12 redstone. Seriously, redstone has been one of the biggest pains in my butt in this series. What we probably should do is set up one of the auto sieve auto sieve, which is 2 blocks of iron. glass pane and iron, and it's just a sieve. So not a huge deal. How much iron do I have? I have 32. Can I make a wild tangent here and go off and do a completely different direction for a minute? Thanks. I hope you guys don't mind. Because if you do mind, oh well. there is that. I can actually do this. I just need some glass. Hey, guess who's got a crap ton of glass, because he totally made a glass thing for making glass. Do I not have glass panes? I do have glass panes. Oh my goodness. I can make one of these. You made. Nice. What do we need for the heavy? Steel. And a heavy plane. Okay. That's not bad. But I can go ahead and place this sucker down. No mesh. And we got foxglove underscore. Interesting, interesting. But I can add a mesh in here. Oh my goodness. Why have I not been doing this from the start? What is wrong with me? This is ludicrously ludicrous. Well, cool. All right. That's good. Can I just break you? I can. Excellent. That, I have just answered all of my problems in this world. So we will be setting that up for getting redstone and lots of other things. But for now, we're going to go ahead and forego anything to do with that. We're going to grab another copper ingot. And what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and make two very useful machines. So let's start out with making two of these guys, like so. And I just realized that I may have kind of screwed the pooch here, but let's find out in just a second. I also feel like I'm doing this backwards. Yes, I am. Da, 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 da. All right, there's one of our machine frames. I don't have any more iron, do I? No, because I'm an idiot. What do I do? I can easily make, I've only got two iron ingots. What are you called? I'm totally blanking. Sag mill, that's what it's called. Sag mill needs a lot more iron. Okay. So here's what I'm thinking, guys. Just tell me if you've heard this one before. We're going to go ahead and we're going to take this. Oh my. And we're going to take our auto sieve that I just made, and I am going to watch it work because I'm an idiot. Yeah. Feed it to while we're at it. That's fast. Ooh, prosperity shards. I do get iron this way, right? From sand? Can sand give me iron? Use. Sieving with gold. Negative on that. Okay, we need, that was the iron mesh, so let's grab an iron stiffened mesh. Pretty much I've come down to the realization that the gold mesh is kind of crap. Because it doesn't give you much of anything except for things like, yeah, there we go, iron. Like the prosperity shards and stuff like that. That's just what I've noticed myself. Boop. Boop. Cool. All right, I'm going to watch this. I'm going to get a bunch more iron and we'll... Ooh. Eulorium dust. I'm also going to hopefully get a bunch of eulorium dust. Do I have any eulorium dust? That's a great freaking question. I don't think I do. I don't think I've sifted any gold in gold sand. I have not. Ooh, hey, more bread. Nice. Oh, and somebody asked if I can put this back into a furnace and make it into toast, and the answer to that question is no, because it's not actually bread. It's rice bread. So, it'd be really cool. I would like that. Oh, man, we're getting a lot of iron. And we're also getting eulorium. Oh, we're getting eulorium, which is amazing, and I want to test it because I believe eulorium is stupid fast. Anyways, we'll be back, guys, in just a second. If you'll excuse me, I need to sit here and watch angrily as this person slowly grinds up my sand into iron for me. So we'll be back in, I don't know how long. A little bit. Eventually. This was the best idea ever. Also, apparently, quartz-enriched dust? Didn't know that. So we get quartz-enriched iron. That's pretty cool. We got a little bit more iron over here. 20 to be exact. We got, I think, a little bit left in here still. 4 ingots. There's one hardening. Yeah, so like 5 more ingots. So that is cool. Cool. Let's go ahead and grab our second one of these. And before we do anything else, because I'm actually... actually out of lava pretty much at this point. I'd like to grab you and see if it's just that easy. Rate is 1x. I'm going to go with Eulorium does nothing. Oh, it actually is smelting. Huh. Is that the Eulorium that's smelting it, or is it just... Is 1x... Oh, no. No, Eulorium is just 1x. Boring. I do know the plutonium recipe is a major pain in the butt. We need 8 cyanite, and cyanite can be made by taking Eulorium and combining it with sand to make cyanite. I'm pretty sure cyanite probably doesn't do anything, so we need to make plutonium most likely. That's going to be a major pain in the butt. So I might work on that. I might not. I don't know. See, we're getting more Eulorium here. We need a lot. We need almost like, what, a stack, I think? Yeah, actually, we do. We need a stack of Eulorium to do it. So, good to know, good to know. Anyways, back on topic. Let's get to the things. We need some more cobblestone. We need a little bit of wood. And let's go ahead and make our sag mill and our other thing. So sag mill is, oh, it's only 1 piston. Never mind. I thought it was 2 pistons. It's fine. I just need some flint. Do I have any flint? I don't think I do have any flint. How do I easily get flint, I say? Obviously that works. Oh, the squeezer with gravel. Yeah. Yeah, if you guys didn't know, you can use the squeezer with cobblestone to get gravel. I mean, this is super derpy and super, super slow. I mean, honestly, I could do this faster with a, whatchamacallit. But we're only doing 2, so it's fine. This will get me gravel like that. And can I pull you out? I can. Excellent. And then we can do it one more time, and we can get ourselves a flint down. Thank you. Nice. And you can actually put a lot of things into this barrel, by the way, in case you didn't know, including lava, which actually catches it on fire. So don't do that. All right, so there's our 3 flint. Nice. And now we can make one, right? Yes. So there is our sag mill. Let's go ahead and make our alloy furnace. Alloy furnace needs some more iron to be wasted like that. Then we need a couple of furni. Perfect amount. Almost like I planned it. And there's our alloy furnace. Oh, yeah. So what we can do with these bad boys is figure out where more of these first cables are at. They're probably in here, would be my guess. And that guess would be correct. Nice. We can... No, I don't want to do that. That looks bad. Looks really bad. Where do I want to put these? I don't even know. I guess for right now, I can just do this and this. This is temporary. Very, very temporary. You're going to fill with some power slowly. For some reason, super slowly. And you're going to fill some power. Cool. So now we have an alloy furnace or alloy smelter and a sag mill, which is fan-freaking-tastic. Because the sag mill can generate dust or... flint, gravel, that, these things. Gravel for us, and then we can put stuff through the alloy furnace and start making some cool things. And that makes me happy. And the other advantage to that is we can also start doing stuff like this, where we can take this iron, we can then take it and dump it into our sag mill here, like this, and it'll give me iron dust back. Watch. So we process this through. And boop, 2 iron grit. Nice. That there in and of itself is super useful. Oh, that did work. That just gave me 4. What? Okay. So totally worth putting this stuff in there. Yeah. It's going to give me a lot of sand. But hey, that's pretty cool. So then pretty much from here, it's just kind of getting things set up and getting them working and doing what they need to do. Dude. Which is cool. So, I'm going to work on a lot of this stuff off camera. We're going to get some more things set up here. And in the next episode, we're going to go ahead because I'm going to need to get a lot more redstone. So, I'm going to work on getting redstone between this episode and next. I don't think there's any way to get, what's it called? Dust. Yeah, the only way to get dust is to hammer it again, which means we would need an automatic hammerer, right? Oh, the crusher can give me dust. Big surprise there. All right, well, the crusher is the only way to get dust, and I'm not going to just build a crusher to get dust. That's a little excessive, but we can do that. So that is definitely an option to consider, but for now, I'm not going to worry about it. We do have this little girl going. She is still, I'm guessing it's a girl, hammering through the sand I'm giving it, and we'll keep processing that through. How we doing? How we doing? We're doing okay. I can still have probably quite a bit left over there, but yeah, that should get us going at least for now and be pretty good. So I'm happy. I'm not gonna lie. I'm not disappointed with where we're at right now in the slightest bit. I'm also very happy about getting a bunch more iron grit out of this. That's actually really cool. So do I have enough for one more? I do. Let's just for fun, let's go ahead and drop this in here and see how it does. Because if this gives me like 3 or 4 again, then hey, give me 2 that time. All right. Well, it's random, but whatever. It's a percentage value, right? This increases main output by 120% and bonus output by 125%. So I think I just got really lucky with Minecraft RNG right there. Pretty dang sure. You are completely out of power, and that's fine. I can just hook those lasers back up. I just didn't like seeing it going across my door, so I got rid of it. But there we go. We got some cool things done, guys. The only thing really from here, what I'm going to work on doing is getting the jetpack, and I'll probably see if I can get Tier 1 and Tier 2 done, which is part of the reason why I wanted to get these two guys, so that we can then go ahead and get those set up so that we can get ourselves, if you look at the jetpacks, Tier 1 is conductive iron, Tier 2 is electrical steel, and the electrical steel is a little bit more expensive, so I'm going to work on getting that together. Should be easy enough to do. Should be not too much. Ooh, can I make you in here? No. Okay, I didn't think so. So I'll probably get to this tier. Could I do energetic? I think I could maybe do energetic, but I doubt it. So we're probably just going to go to the electrical steel. I might start working on energetic because we have a crap ton, a metric crap ton of glowstone from sifting. Can we get the next chest? That's the crafting bench. Not that one. Is it this one? This one, yeah. So we have a lot of glowstone that we could use. So I might even start working on that too. It'd be really cool if I can get the energetic one done. I would be pretty dang happy about that. Anyways, guys, as always, thanks for watching. I am, of course, Dolinmyster. I hope you guys really did enjoy this episode. And if you did enjoy the episode, do me that favor and hit that like button. And if you're new to the channel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button too so you can get all the delicious Dolinmyster in your subscription feed. Oh, yeah. So until next time, I'm, of course, Dolinmyster. Thanks for watching, as always. We'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye.